Hey everybody, how you doing? I'm taking over. Hopefully this is working. I'm Myles. It's a real pleasure and honor to be here. So welcome to my man cave. This is where I spend most of my time when I'm, you know, off the road writing songs. So I figured if we're gonna do this, it's American Songwriter. Let's do this in the songwriting abode, so to speak. Hope you're well. This is obviously unprecedented times we're in. I think we're just all making the best of it. So I'm just thrilled that you are letting me into your home or into your personal communication device. So I'm going to answer some questions, play a few songs, and just have some fun. Keep this chill. I'm gonna admit I'm a little rusty. I've been in songwriting mode for about the last six weeks or so. Really since Alter Bridge wrapped up at the end of February, and then this whole thing started to kind of happen. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to work through this the only way I know how, which is just to write some songs and kind of process that way. And so it's been a productive time. But with that said, I'm not real great at compartmentalizing. Shifting back into playing and performing, I had to kind of dust off the cobwebs over the last few days. So I'm going to give it my best. So I'm going to start with something off of Year of the Tiger. It was my first solo venture, and awesome. It's so cool to see you guys, like Portugal, Chile. This is amazing. So that was my first venture into making a solo record. And the folks at American Songwriter asked if they wanted to have me answer a few questions here. So with that said, what inspired the song and its title? Well, this song was actually inspired by a series of events that happened when I was a kid. My father passed away when I was about four, so the entire record really kind of tells that story. And Year of the Tiger just so happened to be 1974, so that was when all that happened. I know it's a long time ago. This song and this album is a bit of a departure from, I guess, Alter Bridge and what I do with Slash and the Conspirators, and even Mayfield 4 for that matter. It was something I just needed to do to kind of express myself in a different way. I mean, I'm a bit schizophrenic when it comes to music. I listen to a lot of different things, and so I wanted this record to reflect some of those influences. So, with that said, let's dive right in, shall we? This is Year of the Tiger.
In the Year of the Tiger, I won't weep and moan. Got no time for cooling heels, I got to roam. In the Year of the Tiger, I'm gonna roll these bones. Gonna leave behind the heartache that I've known. The only love I've known has slipped away. The only love I've known has gone away. In the Year of the Tiger, I'm gonna stake my claim. Run 1,000 miles beyond this house of pain. In the Year of the Tiger, I got my kin to save. I'll be damned to see them suffer one more day. On a cold, cruel July, we didn't know just when the fierce would arrive. Love alone keeps us alive when we feel we can't go on at all. July. We didn't know just when the bay horse would arrive. Love alone keeps us alive when we feel we can't go on. In the year of the tiger, into an ocean craver, threw his ashes to the wind and walked away. In the year of the tiger, I got no time to waste. Resolution to keep fighting and remain, hey, on a cold, cruel July. We didn't know just when the pale horse would arrive. Love alone keeps us alive. When we feel we can't go on, can't go on and on. In the year of the tiger, in the year of the tiger, in the year.
Cool. So that's Year of the Tiger. So now let's go and do another track here. You guys having fun? Are you good? All right. I guess this is so weird. Like I can't see anybody, but I see you all here. It just touches me to see people from all over checking in. Wow, amazing. Okay. So let's do something by. Let's do some of the stuff with Slash the Conspirators. This is an interesting track for any of you who are songwriters. Something that I've learned over the years is that you'd be surprised what comes to you while you're sleeping as far as ideas. And I don't know what that's about. It's kind of that there's a part right as you are about to head into sleep, into that thing where you're just off into la la land, and also as you're coming to, and then once in a while when you're dreaming. But I find a lot of times ideas will hit me right then, so I usually have something to record with and just hum whatever the melody is, or if I'm at home I'll run and grab a guitar. And about 11 years ago we were on tour with Slash and the Conspirators. I think we were out with Ozzy at that point. I think we were open for Ozzy in the States. And I seem to remember we might have been in Phoenix, and I remember waking up at like 5 in the morning, and let's grab a guitar here. So. And I just hear. I'm like, what is that? What is that? So I grabbed a guitar, kind of put some chord on Rocky. Could be standing out in the sun. I didn't have any sort of lyric, had nothing, just da 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 da. And it was something like that. It was just very kind of in its infancy stage. Fast forward to when we were putting together Apocalyptic Love, and Slash had this really killer. This kind of really cool ascending thing starting on the third and then going up to the flat five. So, and I really loved it. But we couldn't find a chorus, and I remember thinking, what if we just tried that kind of dream state idea? And so we just added as the kind of the answer to the verse. So it was interesting how that whole thing came about, because oftentimes you try, courses are often, as most of you songwriters know, courses can be the most difficult part, because you want the chorus to, it has to have a certain hook, and it has to have a certain vibe that fits with the rest of the song, blah, 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 blah. But as someone in the business once told me, don't bore us, get to the chorus. So you always want to make sure the chorus is solid. So hopefully, this I'm saying these things, and as I'm saying them, I'm realizing this sounds kind of pretentious, but hopefully you enjoy the chorus. We felt like it was appropriate. So let's do that. Let's do the song so you can hear the whole thing in context. This is Standing in the Sun. You're the dark to light, you're never satisfied. You only know the things that will fail to be. The pessimistic one who sees the end to come, where every joy is lost to a tragedy. And still you wonder why you cannot find your peace today. You were meant to live so much more than this, and now if only you could see, you could be standing out in the sun. Still the rain's coming down, rain's coming down. There ain't a cloud inside, still your heart beats cold and gray. Yeah, today. You know it brings me down, the way you drag around your heavy heart, chest like a stone. Well, keep your misery, don't put it all on me, 'cause I got problems of my own. You could be standing out in the sun, still the rain's coming down, rain's coming down. So keep your cloud of darkness and doom off parade here today. And if I could, you know, I set off a spark, I would burn it out, I would burn it all away and purify your jaded, cold, callous heart. Someday I'll find a way. Standing out in the sun, still the rain's coming down, rain's coming down. There ain't a cloud inside, still your heart beats cold and gray. Every day you could be standing out in the sun, still the rain's coming down, rain's coming down. Someday I'll steal a spark, I will burn your doubt away. I'll find a way. What should we do next? Let's do Let's do All Ends Well. Let's do that. So this is a song off of, I believe it was off of Fortress, with which was the fourth record by Alter Bridge. And we've never played this song live as a band for some reason. And hopefully one day we'll rectify that. I remember when we were building the song, I felt like there was something special. There was something about the song I really liked. So we'll do that, but I'm gonna answer some questions first from our friends at American Songwriter. It asks, when you are writing songs, do you think about how they will translate both studio and in the live settings? That's a great question, because they're different. They're definitely different animals. There are some songs, and maybe that's why we haven't played this one live. That's actually fits this song perfectly. I think that we tend to, as Alter Bridge, we tend to gravitate more towards things that kind of have that energy and are more riff based, right? That's a lot of our sound is kind of that balance of the riff with melody, and then a lyric that suits the story and suits the it's kind of like the music is the soundtrack to the visual you're going to provide with the lyric. So yeah, maybe that's why we haven't tried this track live. How has our songwriting or my songwriting evolved throughout the band's career? I think it's evolved a lot. I think it's just, I don't know if it's better. I feel like it's changed. I think that you kind of have your go-to approaches and formulas and chord progressions. And as the years go on, especially once you get enough music out there, you want to kind of try new things, and you absorb different influences, and you try to continue to grow. I mean, otherwise you're just making the same record over and over. And there are artists that have managed to do that for decades, and it works for them, and it shouldn't be any other way for them. And then other artists, it's just for whatever reason, having things shift and move and kind of, I guess, the self-expression or the songs and arrangements take a different form from album to album. I think that's necessary. So, that's a great question. Let's do it. Let's give a shot. Give this one a shot. I haven't played this one in a long time. I think I did this on the solo run, on that Myles solo run a few years ago. So I'll basically do that arrangement. This is All Ends Well.
Could ease your mind, calm the storm inside, pull your drifting heart back from a cooling bit of tide, show you that tomorrow everything will be just fine. Oh, in due time. Somewhere down the road, the stars will show. Somewhere down the road, you're almost home. You're almost home. If you believe in nothing else, just keep believing in yourself. There will be times of trouble, it's gonna hurt like hell. This much I know, all ends well, it all ends well. could heal the scars, show you what you are, bind the wounds of disbelief that brought you down so hard. I would be the tourniquet around your doubting heart. Oh, in due time. Oh, somewhere down the road, your stars will show. Somewhere down the road, you're almost home. You're almost home. If you believe in nothing else, just keep believing in yourself. There will be times of trouble. It's gonna hurt like hell. This much I know. So hard to see, so hard to find. All that you need will come in time. These words of wisdom do not ignore. You've got so much to give. Won't you live? Won't you live on? Won't you live a little more?
That's right.
If you believe in nothing else, just keep believing. It's gonna hurt like hell. This much I know, all ends well. This much I know, all ends well. This much I know, all ends well. This much I know. This much I know, all ends well.
If I can add also, one thing about that song is that I think part of the reason that I relate to that lyric is those were things my mom used to tell me when I was growing up. Just, you know, things that parents, knowledge they bestow on you or words of support and affirmation. And so I think that anytime I sing that, it feels like I can hear my mom speaking through that. And so, definitely something I'm feeling. And going back to the talking about songwriting, I think that's such a paramount part of the process, is especially if you're, well, not just if you're performing it, but if you're writing about something that you can relate to and means something to you, it's going to be easier to translate that to an audience. People are going to pick up on that. If you're writing about things that you just don't have any clue about. At least, you know, speaking for myself, I'm not real great at that. So, I try to utilize subject matter that resonates with me, and hopefully, it will resonate with y'all. So, all right, let's keep moving. Let's keep doing this. I hope you're having fun. I'm having a good time. Actually, this is, you know, I've kind of disappeared since. We got off the road just hunkering down writing, and sometimes when you're in writing mode, you kind of lose your. There's something about performing that is, I forget how much I love doing it. So this is really special. Thank you again, American Songwriter, for asking me to be a part of this. I'm really, really honored. Also, be sure to like their page. Hit that like button. I know that's really important in the Facebook world and algorithms and all that stuff. So let's do another Alter Bridge song. This is this one was actually the genesis of this song was written back in 2002. It was before Alter Bridge, at least the genesis of it. And I remember I was writing, it was after Mayfield, and I was going through, once again, one of these things where I was just writing every day. There was one day in particular where I came up empty and really was bummed. You know, if I go to bed and I feel like I've got something that came from the day, then I feel like I can, something good came from it, and something to kind of look forward to the next day to get up and continue to work on. Well, there was nothing. That day was a dry spell. And you songwriters know that's the worst feeling. Because it's like fishing, you know. I think Tom Petty said that. You know, it's very akin to fishing, and you hope that you catch the big one. So I remember I went to bed and I was like, it was like 2:30 in the morning, and I was like, I can't go to sleep until something happens. I need to try again. So I went down and I went back in the studio. And I had a 335. It was a, which I actually had just bought at a pawn shop. And I remember I tuned it to open G, which I hadn't experimented a lot with that tuning. And I have a good friend that lives up in Toronto, and we toured together. If you haven't heard of Big Wreck, you have to check out Big Wreck. You have to listen to Ian Thornley. He's one of the most brilliant musicians. He can do it all. He's a crazy good guitar player. It's insane how good he is on the guitar. An amazing songwriter, an amazing singer. He's got it all. So we toured together back in the 90s, late 90s, and I remember once I sang a vocal on their second record. I think it was the 10th track, and I remember I went down to the studio and we cut that vocal, and then I remember we were hanging out that night at the apartment they were renting, and Ian was asking me, he's like, hey, do you have anything you could play from the new Mayfield 4 record, the stuff we were working on for the what would become Second Skin. So I played this song called Lila. Let's see if I got that here. Let's see. G. Lila in bloom. So, but it's, you know, just basically moving around that open G chord, or that, as I like to refer to it, the cowboy chord, open G, which is just, you know, kind of it's like one of the first things you learn when you start playing guitar. He's like, well, why don't you tune it to open G? And I was like, wow, I don't know what open G is, because a Big Wreck were known for all their really cool open tunings. So that's where that whole idea came from, was from ultimately from Ian showing me about what open G was. So I tuned the guitar, and this is what came out.
Leaves are on the ground, fall has come, blue skies turning gray, like my love. I tried to carry you and make you whole. but it was never enough. I must go, and who is gonna save you when I'm gone? And who watch over you when I'm gone?
Oops, I'm a little rusty.
You say you care for me, but hide it well. How can you love someone not yourself? And who is gonna say? I'm gone. And when I'm gone, oh, break your fall. Oh, will you play? I can't go on and let you lose it. Ease your pain.
Help me sing this.
And who is gonna save you when I'm gone? And who strength when you're not strong? Oh, watch over you when I've gone away. Snow is on the ground, winter's come. You long to
something else about that song, couple things. The bridge. So that was, so the, you know, the verse and the chorus were something that I had from pre-Alter Bridge. And then Mark had, he had been sitting around for a while, and I loved it. I remember when he would sit around the dining room table when we were putting One Day Remains together. And decide this, and I was like, man, that's an awesome, just powerful, and I remember really liked it. So when we were doing pre-production for Blackbird, we didn't have any sort of, I guess, ballad, for lack of a better word, for that record. So Elvis brought up the idea. He's like, hey, does anybody have something that kind of fits this slot? And I was like, well, I have this. What was the genesis of Watch Over You? But we needed something to finish it out. And so I brought up the idea. I was like, well, hey, what about that really cool bridge concept that Mark has? So we were able to put it together. And that's the interesting thing about Alter Bridge is we definitely, it's like puzzle pieces. It's like sonic puzzle pieces. Now with Slash, a lot of that, Slash will come up with the music, and it's there. And then he hands it to me, and then I'll come up with the melody and the lyric. With my solo thing, it's just, I'm kind of all my own. And with Alter Bridge, Mark and I essentially have these sections of songs. And do you have a chorus for my verse? And it's like the Reese's peanut butter cup of of music in that sense. That's a weird analogy. But on the last record, we didn't do it that way as much because we were touring and we were away. Everybody was, you know, all over the world. And so we had to kind of rely on our own instincts a little more and piece things together. You know, here's a song. It's done. And let's just record it as a band. So that was a different approach. I think we did that on, I think over half the record was made that way. But we still had, like, Dying Light. That was a track where it was more of a, you know, that traditional Alter Bridge approach. So, yeah. And then another thing about that song, which is, I don't know if I've ever told this story before. I'm at the risk of a... This is going way back. And for those of you from my generation, there was a song that you probably remember by Dan Fogelberg called Old Anxiety. I mean, it's just like it was on FM radio all the time, and it was a song that really I really loved because of the story of the song. It tells this really beautiful story about this gentleman running into a someone from a past relationship, and it kind of goes into their experience throughout the evening together. And it's, but what I got from that song, which still tugs on my heartstrings, is the way he ends the song. And there's this beautiful image that he creates with the, and the snow turns into rain. And then the song carries out with the sax playing the Auld Lang Syne melody. And so that was kind of the inspiration in a way for the end of Watch Over You, where you think it's come to an end, you know. And what, you know, and who, gonna da da, and so you, it's got the big ending, right? And it goes back as, snow is on the ground, because it's keeping in with that seasonal thing. You know, the song begins with leaves are on the ground, and it's the seasons are playing out through the verses, and then the last kind of the bookend for the song is the idea of bringing this. And snow in winter always brings a certain heartache, I guess. So it was congruent with what I was trying to convey with the lyric. So there you have it. All right. People are gonna be like, you're listening to Dan Fogelberg? Yes, Dan Fogelberg was a great songwriter. All right, let's do one more. Once again, I wanna thank you all so much for spending your evening. So I see David Cristiano, you said love can only heal. Please, please, please. This is for you, man. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do that song. I'm gonna do that. I'm going to close it out with Love Can Only Heal. So this was a song that was... hopefully the guitar's in tune here. That was written in 2009, I believe. And I did a version of it for the unreleased solo record, the record that never came out. And... when we were putting together the Year of the Tiger, this was a last minute, like, let's try and reapproach this one and put this on the record. So I'm glad that happened, because I feel like the song has found a place in people's hearts. And as a songwriter, that's all you can ask. So I want to play Love Can Only Heal. I'm going to put a little reverb on the vocal. In another life, in another place, some to believe. On a different road, in a perfect space, maybe all the hurts you've known would fail to be. Never mind the pain, 'cause love can only heal.
for light it might reveal. There's a place inside, don't be afraid to feel. Love can only heal. Did it let you go when you lost your way? Did it throw you to the wind and watch you break? Are you hurt you now? Are you ever safe from the empty space inside that you can't take? Never mind the pain, 'cause love can only heal. If only you could trade the dark for light it might reveal. That there's a place inside, don't be afraid to feel. 'Cause love can only heal. La 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 la. Dark for light it might reveal. That there's a place inside, don't be afraid to feel. 'Cause love can only
thank you all so much for joining me. You be safe, and we'll see you next time. All right. Thank you so much for having me, American Songwriter. It's been a lot of fun. All right. We'll see y'all.